Hi friends, we are back today and this is a very exciting video. Why? Because we are going to play around with ChatGPT's GPT-4o. I feel like as I'm saying that, I had to think about, am I saying that correctly? 4o, it definitely doesn't roll off the tongue. As builders, I think most people who are part of this community love building things, whether you are an actual developer, maybe you're on the business side of tech, it doesn't matter. We like to learn about the latest technology and build really cool things. And that is what I want to do today. I was really curious, so I got here, pull up my computer. Wasn't that heavy, I don't know why I did that. So I got here, I went on ChatGPT and I saw I now have access to GPT-4o, as I'm sure we all do. And one thing that stood out to me, which we'll dive into shortly here, is how it's supposed to have better capabilities in understanding images. So I thought, what better than to take some screenshots of some really interesting UI and see if it is able to take that image, understand it, and generate code through that. I thought that'd be pretty cool. It's full on, I mean, as expected with Tailwind, but that's really cool. So that is what we are going to do today, play around with it and see if we can get some really good prompts for it. Hopefully when you watch this video, it will spark some creativity or some creative ideas as far as how you can build your next project or even just understand better the capabilities of this new release. I mean, this is moving quickly and having an understanding of its capabilities, what's possible with it, I think is honestly the best way, the only way to stay up to date with this moving, to stay up to date with it moving quickly. You know what I mean. Actually, that brings up a really interesting thought that I had. I'm going on a little side tangent here. I was at a tech conference the other week and the speaker for the keynote was Jensen, the CEO and co-founder of NVIDIA. I love NVIDIA. I think it's an incredible company and they're doing some really cool things over there. Now, seeing Jensen speak for me was like seeing a celebrity speak, in my opinion. I just think he's really brilliant and delivers really thoughtful speeches. Sometimes maybe a bit controversial, but that's another day. And one of the things he said was technology is moving at the speed of a train. When you're not on the train and you're watching how fast it's moving by, it looks like it's impossible to keep up to date with. It's impossible to ever catch up. But if you choose to get on that train and be a part of seeing what's coming up, testing out these innovations, learning more about it, you realize the train isn't moving that fast. I really liked that analogy because it does do a good job of when you're not, you know, when you're pushing off learning something new or you're resenting it, it does feel as though things are moving so quickly. But when you're being part of it, learning and growing with it, you realize that it is possible to keep up with it, not only keep up with it, but grow with it. And that today is what we're gonna do with ChatGPT-4o. It's gonna take me a while to get used to saying that. All right, let's go. Oh, subscribe, like, leave in the comments other videos you want me to cover. All right, now let's go. Go meaning to my dining room. All right, so you can see here, I am in ChatGPT-4o, and the first thing it gives us is some options. One, to create a workout plan, design a fun coding game, plan a relaxing day, and explain a nostalgia to a kindergartner. That's cool. But you know what? Actually, before we take a screenshot and see how that works, let's kind of just play around with this tool. Let's see what the suggestion of design a fun coding game brings up. Can you help me design a game concept? All right, so now it's starting by prompting us more, which is interesting. Usually it would just output the solution, where in this, it wants to know more. Let's do it in Python. Now this is more chain prompting style, where it's, you know, wanting to have more of a conversation with you. So they want to know target audience, game genre, learning objectives. Target audience is adults, genre, you choose, and it is for entertainment. You pick everything else. I mean, obviously, if you were really doing this for a specific thing, you'd want to get very particular, but for this, I want to see what they have up their sleeve. Code Quest, that's cool. An adventure puzzle game where players embark on a thrilling journey through different worlds. This is cool. Learning objectives, game mechanics. Wow, this is so cool. If this will actually output the right code for us, that's pretty impressive. Sample level. What do you think of this concept? Let's build it. This is actually pretty impressive. Will it build the game for me? That's what I was hoping for. I mean, I wasn't very clear about that, but I just assumed. build the game for me with Python code. It said Python code though. Wow. This is interesting. So it's doing a prototype. And obviously I knew this was a lot of work. I'm a developer, but the way they positioned it was a little bit misleading, where it was like, build a interactive coding game. I thought that would mean the AI would build it for me. So that's a little interesting. Oh, I do like how they said how to run it though, and next steps. Okay, so that's okay. Let's go into REPL it and see if we can run it. And then we will do the screenshot. I'm getting sidetracked here. Okay, so I just entered in the for loop here. And you can see when we go to run it, congratulations, you solved. This is actually really cool. It's very creative. Okay, so that was really cool, actually. I take back my immediate thoughts around 4.0. Now, what I did is I just took a photo, as you can see here, of Udemy's homepage UI. I don't know why I said that so funny. Udemy's homepage UI. And I uploaded it here. So let's go ahead and say, use this image to create code for me to read that will reproduce this. I would like for you to use Tailwind, and you can choose everything else. That's a pretty vague prompt, but let's just start with that and see how it goes. Okay, so they're using Tailwind CSS. I like how it comments it out too, like the hero section, skill section, tabs, da da da. All right, this is pretty cool. This is from one screenshot I took. I know I'm gonna sound so old, but I remember when I first was learning to code and we had to create a to-do list with React. And honestly, I spent like a full week on that because, you know, there was Stack Overflow, but when you're just learning something new, in this case coding, you don't really know how to Google yet, like the proper terms to Google or whatnot. And now, tools like this have completely changed everything. And I'm very interested to see this next generation of builders, coders, tinkers, whatever you wanna call it, who are using this technology. It's so fascinating to me. Gone are the days where you're spending weeks on one to-do list, building it for the first time and feeling those pains. It's really interesting. All right, so, and it does an explanation. All right, so I took that code from ChatGPT and the Tailwind CSS, I inserted it into REPL, and this is pretty cool. So you can see here, I literally just copy and paste it, ran. Let's expand this though. This is so cool. It's pretty much, is it responsive? Let's see, can I do it? And it is responsive. How responsive is it though? Let's see. That's our old code behind there. It's full on, I mean, as expected with Tailwind, but that's really cool. Obviously the images are broken. Did these work? No. But that could be the next step, is prompting it to get these tabs to work, I'm sure. That's pretty impressive, I have to say. The images obviously are missing, but otherwise it's pretty accurate. That's really cool. Let's go back to ChatGPT. Let's go here. And look at this. Yeah, I mean, it's a bit different, but it's very similar. The future, it's here, people. All right, quick recap. I think this is really cool and going to change the way we build, how teams build, even just by these advancements. And I truly believe that there are a lot more exciting things coming with OpenAI that they are going to be releasing by the end of this year, for sure, that some I think they're just holding back on. I don't know why, I just have this sneaking suspicion. It's really fun, and this tech is moving quickly, as I mentioned, but the key here is to be part of it, to try it out through different tutorials like this, just get curious, build things, break things, be part of, what was it that Jensen from NVIDIA said? Be on the train, be someone who is on the train. All right, I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech, coding, future tech, all the good stuff. And leave in the comments any other videos you want me to make, any topics you want me to cover. That's what I'm here for. All right, I'll see you soon. Thanks, everyone.